Let's go on to story number four, reported by KRDO News. So there's a 33-year-old man of Teller County, Colorado. His name is Jeremiah Taylor. And Mr. Taylor is accused of stealing a patrol car from the local sheriff's office. But that's not the story here. The story here is about what he did after he stole the police car. Alex McCarthy, what did Mr. Taylor do after he stole the police car?
Did he rush his wife somewhere? Did he have to, you know, is there an errand that, not an errand, but was there an emergency? And he said, you know what? I need the cop car.
You're actually pretty close. So he decided to listen to the police radio and he heard a domestic violence incident and he decided to respond to it. We have his mugshot, Joel. Let's see this guy's mugshot. There's Jeremiah Taylor right there.
So there's a vigilante.
A call came over the radio for a domestic violence incident. He decided to respond to it in the car like he was a police officer. When other deputies arrived on the scene, they saw him in the patrol car and they ordered him to get out. So he took off. Eventually, he crashed the car and he fled on foot. Deputies caught up to him. So he pulled out a knife and they had to taser him before arresting him. And now he faces just a shit ton of felony charges. Mm. He's going to go away for a while. Okay, Alex McCarthy, have you ever been inside a police car?
Yes.
Let's hear it.
Gosh, it's been a while. So I got into a couple of bits of trouble when I was younger for scrapping on nights out. And yeah, you will find yourself in a cop car pretty quick. Like I can't actually remember the entire thing, but there was like a group fight, right? Like, it all kicked off in a bar.
Gang wars.
Yeah, yeah. But it was one of them where, like, I don't think I was even really heavily involved in that particular one, but the police just scooped us all up. And then we woke up the next day. We'd gone out for my friend's birthday. He woke up in the cell on his birthday. So that was cool. When we finally got let out, it was like, we should probably go grab some lunch. But no, other than that, I think I was 21 the last time I was in the back of a cop car. So...
I love how you say that. Like this was like a semi common occurrence. I think the last time I did it, I was 21.
Well, there was a couple in my late teenage years, but nothing too sinister.
The things that I learn doing this podcast from my guests is amazing. Amazing. Good for you, Alex McCarthy. All right. It's time for story number one, reported by the New York Post. I wish I had five more because you've been a lot of fun, but I'm down to story number one, reported by the New York Post. So there's a woman who owns a bridal shop in Chicago. Her name is Cassia. And she got a call from a groom saying that his bride had bought a dress there and had picked it up, and now he needed to reorder it. Alex McCarthy, why did the groom want to reorder his bride's wedding dress?
The size?
Not a bad guess. They accidentally buried the grandmother in the other one. We've got a video from TikTok, from Cassia's TikTok. Joel, put that up.
So the brother continues to explain to me that basically the bride's dress was hung up in mom's closet. Mom was keeping it for safekeeping. And when all this happened, mom frantically just called the brother and said, hey, can you and so-and-so, which is the groom, can you go and get grandma's dress out of my closet? And so the boys did just that. Being guys, they didn't know better. They didn't know there was multiple wedding dresses in the closet. Honestly, I wouldn't have known, but I would have looked and I would have noticed that it's a different dress. But coulda, woulda, shoulda, this is what happened, right?
So basically, the original dress that the bride bought, she asked her mom to store it in her mom's closet. The mom's mom, which is the bride's grandmother, passed away. And the grandmother had wished to be buried in her wedding dress. So the mom said to the groom and to the groom's future brother-in-law, do me a favor, go into my closet and grab grandma's wedding dress so we can bury her in it. And you know what happened? They grabbed the bride's wedding dress by mistake. And so now the bride's wedding dress was 6 feet under. And so they ain't getting it back. And Cassia said that she is trying to get the manufacturer to make a new one on time if they can. That video, part one of that video, has done almost 6 million views. And so, Alex McCarthy, have you ever been witness to, or maybe you've been a victim of, something related to a wedding that went horribly wrong?
I was best man last year. And I remember, so we wrote the speech. I can't go too deep into this, but we wrote.
Oh God. Okay. I can already say this. So you ended up in the back of a police car. Then somebody's then dog was biting another.
Yeah. Nah, it was just one of them. Like, we did the dry run and we both thought it was hilarious. Me and the other best man, we thought it was golden work. We did like a dry run for, some of the bridesmaids and his partner, and they were literally like, there was like four jokes. They were like, they can't be in there. So we had to kind of restructure the thing. It went okay, Jimmy. I still feel like those jokes. I feel, yeah, come on now, lighten up. But let me just say, on this story, I'm kind of on the man's side. I could make that mistake.
I think any of us could.
That's a plausible mistake to make. I mean, why? That I would put the onus on them. Why are you putting them next to each other, or in the closet, or could have been avoided.
Only thing that I question. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and assume that Granny was at least in her 60s, right? Probably at least in her 60s. So if she was married, say in her 20s, and back then, I mean, she could have been 17 back then. So you think maybe the dress looked a little aged? You know, maybe. And you think maybe when the guys took it, they'd be like, holy shit, this still looks brand new. You know what I mean?
I mean, she probably only wore it once, Jimmy.
True. You know, true.
Could have been preserved. Who knows?
Maybe. I don't see. I'm not up to speed on like the material and how it ages over the decade. You know what I mean?
He might have picked up and he was like, rustic. I don't know. Like, you know, vintage. It might be all the rage now. Yeah.
Yeah, vintage.
If you want to see all our videos about real news stories that are funny, stupid, or weird, click the subscribe button below. Otherwise, we'll start posting spoilers about your favorite new movies.